So a very good evening and a warm welcome to 6:30 Praise.
Yeah, hello everyone. I hope that you're all safe and well and that you've had a good week.
Well, it's February the 14th, so happy Valentine's Day, everybody. I hope you've had a lovely day, either with couples or with families, or even if you're on your own, you know that you are loved by the community and by us, and we look forward to maybe seeing you later on our Zoom meeting.
Yeah, absolutely.
So we are continuing with our sermon series, Learning from Jesus, A Life Rooted in Prayer and Scripture. Thank you for Ian last week. That was really good, wasn't it? Very good indeed. Lots to think about, lots to kind of reflect on as the week has gone on. So what fun installment do we have for this evening?
This week we have Claire Hayward, and she is going to be talking to us about Luke chapter 9, verses 18 to 22. Looking at how Jesus uses prayer to discern the time to reveal his identity.
Ah, that should be good. Yeah. Very good indeed. If you've not met Claire before, she is the church warden at St Mary's and has been part of the parish for a very long time. So hopefully you'll recognise her face once she pops up later on. So as we move forward to starting this evening's celebration, let's take a moment to pause and to pray.
Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for this chance to come together and worship you. We thank you for Claire, for all that she is and the gifts that she brings to us. We ask that you can continue to be with her as she goes about exploring her journey. Lord, calm our thoughts and minds. Open our hearts and fill it with your spirit. Allow us all to hear and feel your word this evening, Lord. And will you be with each and every one of us? And may we know that we are loved by you. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
A story of grace. We have an anthem of hope. We have a reason to praise. We are redeemed and restored. You are the great liberator. You ransomed us from our shame. Now by the blood of the Savior,
I'm gone.
eyes are turning to you. We turn to you. Hope is stirring, hearts are yearning for you. We long for you. 'Cause when we see you, we find strength to face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away. Washed away. Hosanna, Hosanna. You are the God who saves us, worthy of all our praises. Hosanna, Hosanna. Come out.
We're week, we are looking at a reading from Luke, chapter 9, verses 18 to 22. It says, "Once, when Jesus was praying in private, and his disciples were with him, he asked them, 'Who do the crowds say I am?' They replied, 'Some say John the Baptist, others say Elijah, and still others that one of the prophets of long ago has come back to life.' 'But what about you?' he asked. 'Who do you say I am?' Peter answered, 'God's Messiah.' Jesus strictly warned them not to tell this to anyone. And he said, 'The Son of Man must suffer many things and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the teachers of the law. And he must be killed, and on the third day be raised to life.'" So as I spent time reading these verses, many questions sprang to mind. Who was Jesus to his disciples? Who was he back in biblical times? But more importantly, who is Jesus to us in today's world, in society, in our local community of Yate? Who is he to me? How does prayer play its part in Jesus revealing his identity? So many questions, but I have come to the conclusion that questions aren't a bad thing. They enable us to find out more, and we might need to ask more than our initial question. We might not get an answer straight away. We might not get the answer we were looking or hoping for. The questions we ask take us on a journey of discovery. They reveal pathways, ways of finding out more. As a person that has worked in the education sector for many years, I ask and hear many questions every single day. So I have decided to start our exploration of these verses from Luke with children. They say never work with children or animals, but I started thinking about something that everyone is familiar with: games. A firm favourite of mine used to be the game Guess Who. A game with many questions and many answers. The questions are simple and the answers are simple. Can we tell everything about someone by the way they look? No, of course not. So what questions can we ask to find out more about who someone is? I mean, who someone is deep down. Maybe their actions tell us something about a person. So bearing this in mind, whilst there are many crucial spiritual questions, there is none more important than the question Jesus asked the 12 disciples in Luke chapter 9, verse 20, where it says, "But who do you say I am?" Peter answered, "God's Messiah," which was a different answer than that given by the earlier question, "Who do the crowds say that I am?" The answers given were John the Baptist, Elijah, and one of the prophets from long ago that has come back to life. The disciples understood the Messiah as being the reigning king, but didn't really understand the suffering element of the Messiah. Hence, why Jesus mentions his impending death and resurrection in verse 22. Bearing in mind these different ideas of who Jesus is, let's ask the question, does Jesus change? Surely it's not a matter of personal opinion. It's a matter of God's truth, as revealed in his word. This, in turn, is bound to create divisions. How difficult must it have been for the disciples to follow Jesus? For many, many years, people had waited and looked for God's promised Messiah. Many did not see that hope fulfilled. Suddenly, the appearance of a young man preaching and performing miracles. Could it be? He certainly didn't fit the image that people had of what the Messiah would be like. They said he is the one, and committed their lives, to him, even when they faced persecution and people that didn't agree with them. So I challenge you with the question of, who is Jesus to you? Perhaps this question is an easy one to answer for you. Perhaps you're not sure. Perhaps your answer is more complex. Perhaps you need to think about where you are in your journey with Jesus. For me, I was brought up in a Christian family, attended church from a very early age with my parents and grandparents. I always had an interest in religion, such as reading Bible stories. In my teenage years, I became involved more in the life of the church, but looking back, I didn't really ask the questions that maybe I should have. I just accepted what I was told, and things were more of a routine, even though there was that belief inside me. I started to ask questions when at college, studying RE as my main subject during my teaching degree. Over the past few weeks, at the Sunday morning service at St Mary's, on the wall of the youth centre, a quote on the preschool notice board has spoken to me. It says, "Every child is gifted. They just unwrap their packages at different times." It has taken many years, questions and prayer and significant events in my life, good and bad, to come to the conclusion that I am on a really amazing journey to find out more about Jesus. There have been ups and downs, crossroads, and on occasions, dead ends. I liken it to another one of my favourite games as a youngster, Pass the Parcel. With each layer unwrapped comes an action or a challenge. We know there is something precious inside all of the wrapping, but we know that we have to be patient and meet the challenges in order to get the reward. The anticipation, the sometimes unexpected, the excitement, maybe the disappointed. Where are you on your journey? This past year, many people will have questioned their faith. Some may even have found a renewed faith. And some people may have experienced this for the first time. Some may have turned to religion. So who is Jesus to us, and who is he in our community? This past year has been hard for many reasons for all of us. I lost my mum a little over a year ago, and without Jesus in my life, I am not sure where I would have been now. At times, the grief has been painful and unbearable, but there has always been a hand, a warmth, guiding and encouraging me. The pandemic compounded some of these feelings. Through continued questions and prayer, I have come to feel closer to Jesus and understand him just that little bit more. To appreciate the small things that before I had completely taken for granted. Nature, family. So as well as suffering, some positives have come out of this past year. Perhaps Jesus was praying with the disciples when he asked these questions, because he wanted them to think and reflect on who he was to them. They knew who he was, but Jesus made it clear to them not to tell anyone. He perhaps wanted them to listen to his disciples, to decide for themselves who he was, to look at the evidence, to go on their own personal journeys with him. Jesus is known to many as the fine example, the great teacher, and even a prophet. You may be thinking like Peter, "You are the Christ," but do you really understand what that means? Or do you, like me, find yourself praying, "God, show me who Jesus is"? So who is Jesus to us? And how can we share this with our community and make Jesus visible?
The name of Jesus is a refuge, a shelter from the storm, a help to those who call the name of Jesus. Jesus is a fortress, a saving place to run, a hope unshakable. When we fall, you are the Savior. When we call, you are the answer. There is power in your name. There is power in your name. In the name of Jesus, there is life and healing. Chains are broken in your name.
Darkness, my God, that
Let's join together in the prayer of the day. Almighty Father, whose Son was revealed in majesty before he suffered death upon the cross, give us grace to perceive his glory, that we may be strengthened to suffer with him and be changed into his likeness from glory to glory, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Wow, what a great evening. Some great songs, and very much thank you to Claire, who, to be truthfully honest, you know, everyone we've had so far has been directly connected to the clergy of our parish, but to have someone who is our church warden, or just like one of us, who have stepped up and is giving a talk, it's very brave, but a really informative talk this evening. So thank you, Claire.
Well done, Claire. It's really good, particularly being recorded,
Yes,
it's probably even worse than standing up in front of St. Mary's.
And I think there was lots of things that resonated with me, and I think it is an important thing, and I love her challenge where, what does Jesus mean to you? And I kind of reflect on my own journey where church has always been there for me, but over the last, let's say, 10 years, I've got closer and closer and closer to it. And if you asked me 10 years ago, what did Jesus mean to me? I'm very confident that I'll have a very different answer now. And things like Alpha and growing leaders and just connecting with you as a community has changed my connection with Jesus.
Yeah, I think she's made some really good points tonight about who Jesus is to each of us individually and as a community.
Yeah.
Which is really good.
Really good, really good indeed. This the sermon series just gets better and better. There is something every week for us all to reflect on, and I think tonight is definitely one of those again, which is good. So what's really important is, of course, at the end of every 6:30 praise on a Sunday evening, if you've got time, we would love you to click into the notes section and click the link to a Zoom meeting, where if you're watching it right now, you can come along, join in together. There is several of us that do that every single week, and it's good just to catch up with what people have been up to this week, and reflect on some of the good things that have been happening, but also just talk about some of the things that have been maybe challenging. But either way, you are more than welcome to come along, and we'd love to see you there.
Absolutely. I just also wanted to mention to you that Yate Parish are doing a Lent course. It's based on the book Drop Like Stars. There's more information about that up on the website. It's going to be a 6-week course. But yeah, if you're interested in that, it's obviously going to be virtually. But take a look on the website for more information. As ever, I really hope that you are all doing okay. I think we're coming up to our 6th week of lockdown now. It's been really, although a cold week, it is really lovely to just notice those new signs of spring life around the corner. Yeah, the snowdrops. Lambs in the field. I saw lambs in the field going up to the stables yesterday.
Very nice.
And there's signs, I think, that better times are coming.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Well, really good. And as Charlie said, so I hope you guys are okay. If you do need to reach out for any support, no matter how big or how small, please do reach out to the parish of Yate. We're here to help you. We do generally care, and we've got people who can try our best to try and either listen to you or be reactive with anything that needs to be done. So, just reach out. Our website, through Facebook, email. I mean, there's so many ways that you can contact
parish
us. Parish office, of course. Next week, we welcome Hal Snook, who's going to join us next week. He's going to be looking at the subject, Jesus Uses Scripture to Challenge Corruption. That'll be interesting. That'll be good. Mm-hmm. So that'll be next week. But for this week, that is it. Thank you very much for joining us. I hope you guys have a good week, and you guys take care.
Take care, everyone. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.